full wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier. Again, we have to draw circuit diagram. In half wave rectifier, we used only single diode. But in full wave rectifier, we have to use two diodes. That is the main difference. Here I am drawing circuit diagram. Again, you should remember, we must required a AC power source. This is a AC power source. AC power source. We connect the AC power source to a transformer. It is a transformer. Right. This one is a primary coil of the transformer. It is a AC power source. It is input. Input is AC. Okay. Then what's the circuit diagram? We have to take secondary coil. It is a secondary coil of the transformer. You have to connect the diodes there. How many diodes we have to use? In full wave rectifier, we have to use two diodes. We have to use two diodes. Say here I'm using diode number one. Here I'm using diode number two. This diode name is a D1. This diode name is a D2. It is a secondary coil. Yes. Okay. Now I'm joining these two. Here I have to connect one more thing, that is a C, where C is a center tap transformer. This C is a center tap transformer. I explain in this center tap transformer in this class. Here I am connecting the center tap transformer to the ground. This is called, the symbol is called grounding. The circuit is connected grounding. Okay. Now I have to take the outputs. You should remember, in electronics, where we have to get the outputs, we get the output across the resistor only. That's why I'm extending this circuit diagram to take the outputs. Here, resistor I'm using. Across that resistor, I'm taking the current. I'm taking the outputs. Here, this one is a output. And this resistor has a name, you already know that. What is the resistor name? The resistor name is a load resistor. This circuit is giving some load to that resistor. That's why that is a load resistor. It's a diode D1, it is a diode D2. Right. And no need to write the symbols here. P is a primary coil, S is a secondary coil, where C is what? C is a center tapped transformer. C is a center tapped transformer. Center tapped transformer. What is the use of that center tapped transformer? Very simple. The center tapped transformer doing only one thing, that changes the polarities. The center tapped transformer changes. Changes what, sir? Changes polarities. Polarities means what? Polarities means positive, negative. That changes polarities for every half cycle. Every half cycle. That changes polarities for every half cycle. What is the meaning, sir? See, here I am taking a AC current. This is a positive half cycle. It's a negative half cycle. You know that. Positive half cycle, negative half cycle. You give some names. It's a first positive half cycle. It's a second positive half cycle. Okay. It is a some A negative half cycle. It is a B negative half cycle. See, this positive half cycle, first positive half cycle is going. For the first positive half cycle, this point, you take this point as A, you take this point as B to understand easily. For first positive half cycle, for this reason, this A is in positive polarity and this B is in negative polarity. Now tell me, which diode in forward bias? diode D1 is in forward bias. Why, sir? Because it is a P, it is a N. It is a P, this one is a N. P side is connected to positive terminal. That is a forward bias. And this one is in reverse bias. For first half cycle, I am explaining, for first positive half cycle, diode D1 in forward bias and diode D2 in reverse bias. What I am using, sir, here? I am using a center tapped transformer. What is the use of center tapped transformer? That changes polarities for every half cycle. This half cycle completed. Now you check for negative half cycle. This negative half cycle is coming there. What is doing? Automatically, this A is in negative and B becomes positive. Who changed, sir? The center tap of transformer changing. Now tell me, which one is in forward bias? For this negative half cycle, diode D1 in reverse bias, diode D2 in forward bias. What that? You should remember that point.